Ed.
You got this from me, right?
Yeah, I did.
You weren't on that list, but I added you. I have a couple different lists, but I thought of you because I've seen you recently.
Oh, cool.
I sent it to a different list.
Oh, okay.
Yahoo only gives you 100, then after that they won't let you do it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Francisco,
right,
amigo.
Hey, Eddie. How are you? How's the campaign?
It's going well.
Look, that's
my good friend Anthony Holdsworth.
Oh, that's a nice picture.
Yeah.
That's you on your deck, huh?
Signed the bill, which we got passed, to give people driver's license and IDs if you weren't, you know, if you didn't have the pinche papeles, right? So the governor would not sign it. So we started going up to Sacramento once a month, and we would follow the governor with signs, especially when he was doing ribbon cutting ceremonies, and embarrassed the shit out of him every single time. Right? Well, fast forward, find this out, check this out. Very interesting.
I'm listening, bro.
God don't like ugly. What if Governor Schwarzenegger get caught doing? He had a baby, a brown baby, from a woman from Guatemala who was his maid, the live-in maid. Now, you know, when that came out, I said, God, no wonder he didn't want to sign the bill. He didn't want this woman from Guatemala to have an ID.
That's right.
He kept her like a prisoner. It reminded me of the days when they used to do that to the brothers and sisters who they brought over here from Africa. Right? Yeah. You've heard those stories of the white men who used to rape the black woman and have sex with them and have babies with them and hide them, you know? So I share those two stories with you because today, let's talk about Lennar.
Talk about it.
Let's talk about what they, dirty deals they did in the Bayview Hunters
That's
Point.
Right.
They convinced the politicians who are paid to play, both ways. They got them to agree to give them all that land for dirt cheap. And what else did they do? They hired a company to do the inspection. And do you wonder what kind of company that was? And if you look and research them and look at their track record in terms of what kind of track record they have for cleaning up and inspecting properties. But there was a group of people who consistently stayed on track on that company and demanded the city of San Francisco to investigate them, which the mayor failed to do, which the board of supervisors failed to do, which the city attorney failed to do, which the district attorney failed to do. But guess what? They went to the federal government and they finally got somebody to listen to them and say, you know what? Let's take another look at this. And now that they're taking another look at it, guess what? Now Mayor Ed Lee's saying, oh, let's do an investigation. Now Supervisor Malia Cohen is saying, let's look and investigate this. Well, hell, if they would have done that from day one, they would have found that they were dirty. Lennar is dirty. So for reals with us in this battle to stop luxury condos from being built at a crisis time when we need affordable housing. Please put it in.
Thank you, Roberto. Because we can do it, right? We organize, we go out there, we go to City Hall. When there's going to be the appeals, we can
go
on, we know, and we're together, and we're organized.
I feel bad because I met a lot of people.
Everybody hear me? My name is Roberto Alfaro, and I was born and raised in this neighborhood. I was born in a family hospital down the street. I'm proud of being part of this city, and I ain't going nowhere.
Investments in our neighborhood on the backs of our people.
That's right.
There's a speaker that's coming up next that has been speaking to this for quite some time. He's an ACE member. His name is Archbishop King. He's going to say a few words. Thank you.
Law Action Movement. We met every Tuesday night for 5 or 6 years to get them to move an inch. We're not going to just come down here in one day. But I know when you talk about the law, you're talking about faith. Why would I say that? Because faith makes promises that he never intends to keep. And that's what Lennar do. They got a good sales pitch. But they have no intention of doing what is good and right for our people. Black and brown, united together, cannot be defeated. So we're coming out to let you know. I was supposed to be down at City Hall because we still fight these rogue police that's killing our youth. There's a blue ribbon hearing on the... If anybody, I don't know why we need a hearing to know that the police are big. But anyway, I couldn't be there because my heart was here to let you know. We prophesied this when we were in Fillmore, when they came for the Fillmore. We don't thank you, you're next. We don't mention you next. And some of the folks from the mission stood with us. Some of them went to sleep, not just in the mission, but in Bayview and Fillmore. We are now outnumbered. We are out-organized. And we need to organize and organize and organize. But the best way to organize is to become aware of the issue. What are the facts? What's really going on here? Lennar talking about taking space in Bayview to build high-rise and take office space. And we got people that are homeless. Why don't we go over to the mission and identify some of that property over there in Bayview and table the gift of land to the people? We used to say it like this: free up the land, white man. It's about land. It ain't about promises. We got to get the developers out of the picture. They come to Bayview. They give a goddamn pushing a wheelbarrow, waving a flag, hauling a water hose, while they bring people from outside the city to do the work. And when the work is over, no more flags to wave, no more water hoses. You get shut down, and your job is over with, and you can't even afford to buy the stuff that you've been flagging for them to build. So what we want to say is that keep the thing happening. I'm with the Mario Woods for Justice. We had a marriage with the black and brown community. Alexis Nieto needs some justice. Yeah. Huh? Mario Woods needs some justice. What is that justice? King policeman going to jail for murder.
Okay.
How do you meet with a man? A white man for 6 hours with an automatic weapon, threatening to kill police, but you got time to meet with him for 6 hours. You can vacate 2 blocks of the citizenry while you negotiate with him. Alexis Nieto didn't get a negotiation. Mario Woods was dead in 30 seconds.
Nice to meet you.
We got to know all of this is interconnected. It's about getting with us, whether it's gang and junkies and taking the young men off of the street, or whether it's all of this kind of stuff talking about it building high-rise. The mission district is really the land of true cultural experience in this city. Oh, I wish somebody was here from the mission. Some pressure on the DA Gascon to tell him it's
condos.
Where? What happens to the neighborhood? People get displaced. They are selling this as a jobs program, but as far as I've heard, it's going to sell to a tech company where currently the, let's see, what is it, workers, African-American workers in tech are 2% of the population. So do we really think that they're going to be creating jobs in the Bayview permanently?
No. 4% Latino.
4%. What's really offensive, too, is that there's been no community outreach to the Bayview. This is being shoved down our throats. They ask you to vote for it on October 8th. Please vote no on O and tell your friends.
No.
No on O.
No. No. Hell no.
God,
hell no.
Okay, now we're going to, we actually have one stop. We're going to be marching to 22nd and Southwest, where we're going to have a few more speakers. It's very 22nd and Southwest. There is a building there. One of our fellow neighbors here in the community is seeing a good stretch of eviction. They're going to be selling the property. So we're going to go out and support our fellow neighbor who lives at near 22nd Tabernacle. So if we can actually pile up so we can start marching to 22nd and Tabernacle.
You're late.
All right, hey, getting ready to march.
Thank you.
hear it. Can't hear it. Can't hear it.
A lot of time, and I've seen people evicted and forced out of their homes.
So the first, I'm sure as most of you can imagine, the first thing that came to my mind was addiction, displacement. I'm here speaking on behalf of my family members that can't be here, that are in the building right now but are disabled and elderly. And don't really have anyone here to fight for them, to support them, but they appreciated though that I was here. They really did trust me when I said it, that they really appreciated everyone here to support them, to support us. We don't plan on going anywhere. You know, we're gonna fight to the nail. But pretty much we always have. You know, I remember walking up and down this block over here with my grandmother. She was now burned down on Mission Market. You know, that's where I got my, that's what I know. And so I'm really fortunate to be able to stand here and have a fighting chance because a lot of our community did it. It's a lot of my mind, so I have to write a couple of these things down. So the house, you know, went on sale, was put on the market, and the asking price was really high. And so the first thing I did was I reached out to some of the community organizations, and I was aware of the land trust and the small time acquisition program. Unfortunately, we didn't have enough time to purchase the building, and the building was sold. And thanks to the community, we were able to put pressure on the prospective buyers. A lot of people that would have forced us out, they didn't buy the building because of the pressure that we put on them when they came through. So they came through and purchased the building as an LLC. Well, you know, lo and behold, less than 2 years later, the building, as I've been told, has been put back on the market. They did a few minor repairs. The building, as you can see, I mean, it's not the really spectacular. Although, to me, in my heart, it is. It's a beautiful home. And so, excuse me. So I really want to ask, respectfully ask the candidates running for District 9 that they support us and sign the pledge for the right of first refusal, because I do believe truly in my heart that families should have a right to negotiate a purchase, to be able to sustain the homes that they love and they cherish. And, people like myself call this neighborhood home. And so that said, Julian,
so everyone get ready. This is one of our next campaigns that we're going to be pushing forward. About the review, and I know when this is my baseball field right over here, and I know when they put these buildings, I couldn't see Vernal Heights anymore. Give it a hand to our supervisor, our candidate, for District 9, for supporting my family and I.
And over here? No, back then.
Okay. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you again for all of us, for our candidates coming out today and supporting us.
With these friends, I
Yes, I couldn't wait to get up there. This is my thing. I like people to hear. When I come out and rally, I like to rally. You know, this is not an easy task, what y'all doing. You know what I'm saying? But you're fighting for something. And when you're fighting for something, you got to let them hear you. You got to let them hear you to the point where they know that you for real and you're not playing. This is not a game. This is for real. People get kicked out of the house. Gentrification. They say that word like it's all dressed up. It ain't nothing but racism. That word is a racism word. And to move the tour from one district to another district. Come on, now Lennar is all over the place. I represent Bayview 120 where I live, man. But I represent Green Acres for environmental health and justice. You know, with Bradley Angel and Marie Harrison. I do this all the time. And I want y'all to know that y'all fighting for a cause that's worthy to fight for. And that's why I came out here to walk with y'all, to march with y'all, and to talk with y'all. And y'all keep up the good work. But when you out here, you got to be loud, and you got to let them hear you, and you got to let them know that you're for real.
Yeah. Woo! Woo!
Thank you. Anyone else want to make an announcement?
How can you be so quiet and be so low and you're gonna get kicked out?
Hello.
You know, I moved here in 66.
And
the old Fillmore was still there, but they were just talking about putting back in the 70s, redoing that. That's gentrification. And you know, all them people that usually live there don't live there because they can't afford to stay there.
According to the
affordable
law,
housing, affordable housing for who?
You cannot be evicted. But if this is happening too often, we need to speak out. We need to say no more evictions. No more evictions. No more evictions.
Just say hi to Bradley. He know me.
We don't make that kind of money. They're taking $7,000 to pay for one bedroom apartment. That's crazy because they're making $20,000, $30,000.
We make only maybe the most 3,000. Yeah! No more evictions!
Yeah! Yeah!
That's what I'm talking about. Pump it up!
No
more evictions! No more evictions! No more evictions! No more evictions! No more evictions!
¿Se puede? Are we going to unite? Are we going to organize against eviction, against Lennar, against the vermin coming to our community? Are we going to do it?
Yes!
Si se puede! Si se puede!
Si se puede! Si se puede!
Si se puede! Thank you. I want to thank all the organizations who took part of this action, the community, the tenants who came out from different. I want to thank anyone else that I'm reading out, anyone who took part of this action. I just want to thank you for coming out. Si se puede!
Si se puede! Si se puede! Si se puede!
Thank you.